is, but it will never be the same. Please help me welcome our speaker, Darron.
Please continue on with your lunch. Like I said, for folks over here, you can turn your attention this way. Just go to the whiteboard. I don't pretend to be an artist, but we're going to try. AJ, thanks. Thank you again. I'm sure all of us have said the same. I know I said it a lot growing up, but it will never be the same. Now, as a child, I used to say it a lot. Now, as a child, I also had a lot of catastrophes. My action figure guy broke, but it'll never be the same. Well, my parents, and if you have parents like I did, they had the same, but we're going to have to live with it. But it'll never be the same, but we're going to have to learn to live with it. I think sometimes we get so comfortable with our surroundings, with our job, with our home life, that we sometimes start to take things for granted. We sometimes look at life as an uphill climb, with our work, with our home life, with our financial situations. Then when we hit a peak or a plateau, we enjoy it, and as we should. Our job's going well. Financially, things are sitting good. We're healthy. Maybe we worked on a house project to improve our house, and after a lot of hours and labor, we're enjoying all of our hard work. And we get to this point, and life is good. Then something happens. It causes a little bit of a downhill swing. Maybe somebody retires that you've really relied on at your workplace. And you think, but things will never be the same. Maybe somebody's hours got cut back, or somebody loses their job, and financially, things get a little tight. Can't afford everything that you're used to purchasing. And you think, but things will never be the same. Maybe one of your kids gets married, and they move out of the house, and they're on their own for the first time. And you think, but things will never be the same. Maybe someone dies, and immediately you think things will never be the same. I think sometimes these downhill swings serve as a wake-up call for all of us. Not to take things for granted, not to get too lax in how we feel about people. Don't get too guarded, and maybe let your emotions show a little more. This diagram I went through back in 1999, and many times since. But back in 1999, I was a senior at Michigan State. And I worked 3.5 years on the uphill climb, taking classes, working through college, and in my last semester, I had the dream schedule. Classes, 2 days a week. Both days, I was done by noon. What to do with all that, right? At the same time, I was doing an internship. And the talk was that there was going to be a full-time position opening here in a couple months. And of course, I'd apply for it. I was also had a seat on the third row off the court at Michigan State basketball games. Life was really good. They were doing well. They were winning. Talk of a Big Ten championship was in the air. And I just came off a Christmas break with family and friends. And I don't know if it was because I knew I was getting close to being out of college, getting close to being on my own, or something in my belly said, you need to be thankful for all the people and the things you have in your life. Life was good. I was enjoying life. And then something happened. I got up to go to my internship. 8 o'clock in the morning. By 9 o'clock, my roommate was calling me. And says, Darron, I think you need to come home. I said, well, why is that? And kind of hemmed and hawed, and he said, you just need to come home. And I said, well, I'm not coming home until you tell me. And something in my gut didn't feel right. And he said, Jack died last night. Jack was another one of our roommates. And at 21 years of age, immediately I said, things will never be the same. Jack had a whole laundry list of medical issues, born with a hole in his heart, seeing more doctors than we'd ever care to, was on more medications, but he defied the odds and never complained. He He wasn't expected to reach age 10, and he reached age 21. He was an inspiration to a lot of us. So all of a sudden, things kind of went on a downhill slide. Served as a wake-up call. I'd like to think I did not take Jack's friendship for granted. But it was on this downhill slide where I started to doubt myself to say, did I ever tell him what my friendship meant? And I think in this holiday season, there's no better time than another. Tell the family, tell the friends, tell the coworkers, tell the garbage man, because they play important jobs too, what they mean to you. And you don't have to get all sappy and sentimental, but just pat them on the back. Show appreciation. It's how we deal with the changes, these downhill swings, that make us stronger people and better people. And it's how we deal with the change that gets us on the next uphill climb to reach the next plateau. I haven't met too many people that like change. Change can be hard, but it's how we deal with the changes that get us back up to the enjoyable life. It's true. Change leads to the saying of, but things will never be the same. But as my parents said, we'll have to learn to live with it. We had to learn to live with not having Jack around any longer as a roommate. But it wasn't 2 months later after Jack's funeral, I got that full-time job. 2 months after that, I met my wife. And it wasn't long after we were back up here. And we're gonna have a ton of these little drawings, peaks and valleys, if you will, throughout our lives. But it's how we deal with the downhill that correlates how quickly we get back up here. Have a great afternoon.